bike lanes in front of those sidewalks, so that's the best place in the world to do that. And that was a lot of fun early in the morning. And then left out, there's a lot of lines explaining what's going on here.
the report, there are seven major areas that we take a look at. The first is looking at expenditures, which serves for our improvement market, and the loading for expenses. And we had no exceptions in those areas. The next area we looked at was most effort. And here we compare discretionary to road expenditures, which serve as a means of finances, as much as their basic level.
Grown 4.25
final area that we reviewed were indirect costs allocated to the project. And this was in that case, we allocated indirect costs to the project. Three of those would be as an indirect cost plan, we moved by cost of agencies. And of the 27 agencies, they all have the methodology we've been using in the last 2 years or so. I really expect to see that it will take a few years to go back and take a look at the methodology. We review the methodology and the agreements of what we need to recommend to the MFA during the next year to review the methodology formal to make sure that it's with their operating. The results of all the procedures and the detailed reports and all the findings, along with any matters that are possible, are included in the individual draft reports that are all posted on the website.
Any other comments, questions, or thoughts?
rail system goes down in cost. So, when everything is increasing, then you kind of find a symbol where things have to go down 6.4% and the other thing that's been considered. Certainly, you can say, which is a big chunk of the money. So, I think in both of us, you know, just the controlling cost. We have this experience in terms of the sales process. We can do some of the things that probably are more or less limited.
Article 3 is specific to some sort of protection for the non-motorized class. which is why I'm listening to the students from functioning and using people's thoughts. And these funds are then returned to the county community board's local transportation funds back to us, which is especially hard for all community members. A fund is a resource from the annual audit and community property and said funds, a notification from a local jurisdiction during the year, or through a review by the active transportation project and staff of the agenda. In all cases, we end up confirmed with the local jurisdiction through agreement to the completion of the project and said funds are needed prior to requesting an adjustment to the jurisdiction. The fiscal year 15 community audit included projects that were noted as complete by the jurisdiction of the local community cost of over $316,000. In the review by the active transportation project management staff, there were several projects that came up to be filmed at companies that had been funded for approximately $79,000. All completed projects have been given to work to build companies. We have to have this company to allow funds from $395,000 to be available to community policies and larger spring projects. Continuing to review those projects and companies are all conditioned to be locked down and are made available for all communities. The Transportation Committee asked to adopt the resolution of the 2016-7-7-2-1, approving the measures for transportation in the Department of Housing 3, which is from various completed funding activities that include the coal model, the new and national community committee, the transportation company hope, the people of Rockland.
Thank you so much. I want to know.
Good morning. Last month, the Department of Transportation announced the availability of funding for both the Tiger and the Boston Grant programs. Under the Tiger program, there is $500 million available nationwide. The Tiger will have a significant regional or national impact. Under the agency's Tiger program, obtain the necessary environmental clearances and be ready to operate by September 2019. Similar to the last round, the U.S. DOT is looking for projects that support safety, city of good repair, economic competitiveness, environmental sustainability, and quality of life. Based on these criteria, staff recommends that Canada submit applications for the San Diego River-based Global Connect project and the Environmental 5-125-11 Southbound Connectors project. The San Diego River-based Global Connect project is a central agency project that would construct a 1-mile segment of second lane track to close the gap between two existing double track segments. And will be included in the engine fuel tank rail and utility bridge with the double track bridge crossing the San Diego River. Completion of the project will result in a 7-mile continuous stretch of double track and the replacement of the nearly 100-year-old railway bridge, which will result in additional capacity, fewer bridge piers, and deeper foundations for beautification. The estimated grant cost for this project is $11.5 million. The South Bend Connector project would construct a critical freeway-to-freeway connector just north of the Arizona Mesa Land Board of Entity. It would be southbound State Route 125 to westbound Environmental Park. Completion of the project will reduce local traffic congestion on the local railroad network and provide direct connectivity to the SR-125. Additionally, San Diego is partnering with the General Services Administration to implement pedestrian improvements that will provide a direct connection to the pedestrian border crossing and processing facility. The estimated grant for this project is $20 million. Both of these projects are included within the current improvement program are ready to go, clearly benefiting regional and national commitments, and need the necessary 80/20 match under the federal program. Today's program we're talking about is the Pathways Program. This program is a project that will address critical freight issues and the nation's values and members, and that are ready to go by September 2019. There's $800 million available nationwide under this program. The minimum cost for large projects is $100 million, with the minimum grant award under this category being $25,000. Given these parameters, staff have identified the North Coastal Multimodal Improvement Project, the environmental frontier in Iowa's Marina Double Cut Project, and the Ocean Nation Expansion Project, with the most competitive applications under the Pathways Program. The North Coastal Project is a transient community project that consists of a series of freight mobility efforts in northern San Diego County, including construction of Eagle Valley Lane in this direction from Interstate 5, from State Route 78 to Costa Avenue, and the replacement of the high-rate and rail bridge over the Bison River Basin. The estimated grant cost for this project is $60 million. The Valley to Marina Double Cut Project also is a transition to cost, more than 2.6 miles of dedicated track from State Route 52 to this project over a half an hour. One Marina Double Cut students on both sides of this project, the result will be a continuous 10.3 miles of double cuts and free freight operations in the Rosemary and Coastal Rail Corridor. The estimated grant cost is $50 million. In turn, the Rosemary and Coastal Rail Corridor will construct a new four-lane highway to extend State Route 11 by about a mile. The highway will start at East Marina Floating Drive and extend to the proposed new Oceanway Street for the entity. As Jamie mentioned at the Board of Directors meeting last week, Kermit is working with Kermit on this application, to submit it as one of the three submissions that the state will provide to the Pathways Program. The estimated grant cost is $55,000. Again, each of these projects are in the current stand of CIP, meet the program's budget and match requirements, and are funded ready. In addition, given the pivotal role of the I-5 and the U.S.-Mexico border on the regional, state, and national freight network, the estimated new service offer the most competitive transfer standard to be received as well. And to move into the software for those who can support some standard for their own grant proposals, I recommend providing letters of support for those projects that are completely consistent with the legal use number. With that in mind, the Transportation Committee asked the three ways to propose regional projects to middle for the federal fiscal year 2016 Tiger and Staff for the Integrated Program. That is the support.
Maybe a little clarification on the application. I know it's worse than we were trying to get started with the application of the ground. So, therefore, you might have an opportunity. How does that affect conversations with other agencies? Do you think that's what I'm saying?
So I don't think it affects competition. I think we still have the last round with the Tiger Grant, and we kind of have got at least two related to the border, and the last round actually the port got one. We both submitted, so probably I don't think estimating is limiting or doing it really effectively is really just decided by USDOT. So I think the grant is a project that will, and it needs, you know, kind of identify who in the program to be set already.
Kind of a grant to the Midwest, and it'd be nice to know, you know,
count the rolling thunder that he's been as we've been able to do through the time.
Look for it.